So hopefully you've had a chance to complete your photosynthesis concept map. For photosynthesis, we have two steps. We have the light-dependent reactions and the light-independent reactions, or the Calvin cycle. And both of these steps are going to occur in the chloroplasts. For the light-dependent reactions, we have two inputs. We have light and water. We have three outputs. We have oxygen, NADPH, one of our energy carrier molecules, and a little bit of ATP. The oxygen is going to leave as a waste product, and the NADPH and the ATP are going to be used in step two. So we have three inputs into the Calvin cycle. We just mentioned NADPH is going to come from the first step, and the ATP that's generated in the first step is going to be used in the second step. And this is where we use carbon dioxide. We have one output of the Calvin cycle, and that's going to be G3P. G3P can then be converted into glucose or any of the other macromolecules that the plant needs to survive. So if we look at the overall summary equation, we can figure out where the reactants and the products are. So water is going to go into the first step. Carbon dioxide is not going to be used until the second step. Light is only used in the first step. And pigments are found within the chloroplast. So that's the only way this reaction can happen. You have to have all of these parts. If we look at the outputs, the arrows that are actually leaving this system, the only things that leave this system are going to be glucose, starting from the form of G3P, and oxygen, serving as a waste product of photosynthesis. Again, I hope this concept map helps you visualize what's going on with photosynthesis. And now let's talk a little bit about which organisms are actually doing photosynthesis. So I think when people think about photosynthesis, we obviously think of plants. And plants are one of the main groups of organisms that use photosynthesis. But there are some bacteria and some protista, single-celled organisms, that also do photosynthesis. The protista that do photosynthesis will also have chloroplasts. Bacteria, remember, are prokaryotic cells. They aren't going to have membrane-bound organelles, and they aren't going to have chloroplasts. But if you're going to do photosynthesis, you have to have pigments. And so these bacteria just have the pigments floating around inside the cell. Many of the phytoplankton out in the ocean are bacteria that can do photosynthesis. And in a really amazing statistic, 70% of the photosynthesis done on the planet is done by phytoplankton, small microscopic creatures floating around in the top layer of the ocean absorbing sunlight energy. That means all of the rainforests of the world, the grasslands, crops, forests, all of those plants doing photosynthesis add up to only 30% of the photosynthesis that's happening on our planet. It's a pretty amazing amount of photosynthesis, and it tells you how big our oceans really, really are. We don't think about them much because they're not where we live, but they really have a huge impact on us and the planet. So who does cellular respiration? Little review, all living things. So plants are going to do both photosynthesis and cellular respiration. We're going to do cellular respiration. Even those little phytoplankton out in the oceans are doing photosynthesis and cellular respiration. So this is something that's common to all organisms.